Mr. Speaker, I want to extend my gratitude to you for allowing today to have another memorial resolution. I know we had our two colleagues that passed away, and they were very heartfelt and very moving. I had a gentleman who worked in my district office for a number of years who passed away about a month ago. His name is Kevin Keller. And Kevin was a mailman. He worked for the U.S. Postal Service. He used to deliver mail to our district office. And a number of years ago, he came to us when he knew that one of our people in the office was leaving and said, "Hey, I got a son that just graduated from college, and he's looking for a job. Maybe he'd be a good fit here." So he sent him in, and we talked to him, and sure enough, we hired his son, Sean Keller, who worked for me for about 5 years in the district office, did a really wonderful and great job, and went on to bigger and better things down in Washington, D.C., got a job with Homeland Security, and has been down there for a while, and we hired some other people to take his place. In the meantime, his dad, Kevin, later retired from the post office, from U.S. Postal Service, after 32 years as a carrier. And he came to us one day and said, "Hey, I'm retiring, and if you have an opening, I'd like to do that, the same job my son did." And sure enough, things worked out the way that we hoped they would, and we were able to hire Kevin. He worked for us for about 5.5 years. And you would have never known anything about his postal background because he really fell in love with being a state employee and working in our district office. And the main reason that he liked it so much, he liked politics, he liked being around the political system and hearing stories about what was going on and watching it on PCN. But more than that, Kevin liked to help people. And we all know what that's like in our district offices. We all know that we like people in our district office who, when a constituent walks in that door, whatever their problem is, we treat it as the most important problem in the world that day. Because to that person walking in the door, that's exactly the way they feel. There isn't anything more important. That's why they're there. And once we take care of it, they go on to all the other problems. But Kevin was that kind of an employee, that kind of a person, and that kind of a friend. He and I would talk sports and about family and politics and all those kinds of things. But he was just became a great friend of mine. He was really the same generation as I was. He was a lot better at a computer than I was, certainly, which I'm not sure how he learned that, I guess from his son, Sean. But nevertheless, Kevin did a wonderful job. And one of the things that Kevin did towards the end of his time that he worked for me, a couple of years ago, when we were talking about the unclaimed property that is out there for constituents, he really delved into it. And he said, "You know what, I think there's a better way for us to outreach to people to find unclaimed property for our constituents." So he and the rest of our staff, and Kevin led the charge, he had spreadsheets and all those kinds of things, and we were able to find the last 2 years $800,000 for our constituents from unclaimed property, and a lot of that was because of Kevin Keller. So about a year and a half ago, Kevin had some illness issues that did not get better, and over time, Kevin went through a lot and fought that illness and recently has succumbed. And it was very sad for all of us because we, obviously being close to him, and many of us here in the room have had relatives and friends in the same situation where we watch them fight the good fight, but eventually lose. Mr. Speaker, we have here with us today, if you don't mind, I'll just introduce them very quickly here because I know time is an issue, but we have Kevin's wife, Sue Keller, is here.
Sue, please stand.
You can stand. We have my former employee and Kevin's son, Sean Keller, with his wife, Sabrina, and their two kids, Luca and Landon. And we have Kevin's daughter, Shannon Jeffries, who is here as well. Let me just end as we say goodbye to Kevin here today in a formal way. A little poem that I was able to find that goes like this. God saw you getting tired and a cure was not to be. So he put his arms around you and whispered, "Come to me." With tearful eyes, we watched you suffer and saw you fade away. Although we loved you dearly, we could not make you stay. A golden heart stopped beating, hard-working hands to rest. God broke our hearts to prove to us he only takes the best. God bless you, Kevin.